कैन आई देन इनवाइट सजी नारायण जी टू जस्ट कम फॉरवर्ड विथ सम ऑब्जर्वेशंस ऑन द नेशनल एजुकेशन पॉलिसी. आफ्टर दैट आई रिक्वेस्ट सुंदरम जी टू कम फॉरवर्ड एंड मेक सम ऑब्जर्वेशंस. एंड देन वी हैव डॉक्टर मालिनी भट्टाचार्य ऑल्सो हुज हियर. आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट हर ऑल्सो लेटर ऑन टू मेक सम ऑब्जर्वेशंस. सजी जी.
Thank you, Irvan ji. First of all, I should thank Sridhar ji, Professor Sridhar ji, for becoming a part of a historical effort. This is after, I think, after Kothari Commission report. This is the first time a fundamental, basic change of vision is taking place in the education sector. So I congratulate you being a part of such a great, great Himalayan effort. Now, when we look at the whole affair, what is the vision conveyed by the new NEP, this NEP? I think there are two, three, many things you have mentioned from what I have gathered in my mind from many discussions that have taken up, already taken up. One is an Indianizing effect is coming first time, because after Macaulay's time, this is the first time an Indianizing effort has taken place. Second is vocationalizing the education, because skill training is a very great challenge. And everybody says whatever the government has done efforts for the last several years, it is not going for a takeoff stage. It is all running in the runway, but not taking off. Only if it is related to academic sector, then only skill development will be in a large scale that will take care of the needs. So vocationalization also is a great thing. And third thing is a sort of the students' inquisitive faculty is being developed, given more importance. A sort of analytical skills, research is given prominence. So these are all some of the highlights of this thing. So for that purpose, it is going to be a great historic document, everything. Now, when we, so I don't want to go into what you have said and commenting on those, but I mean, the discussion, there are some reservation about this thing. I want to some clarification on that, because you are the most relevant authority for all of us, because you have been right from the beginning, you know, each and every clause, full stop, comma, you have studied. So only that, I think that is why I want to this thing. One is for personality development. That is squarely what Swami Vivekananda said about education. So it should develop the manifestation of divinity in man. All those things it is there. So what is the personality development content in the NEP? Second thing is. Many a times, many people say that the success of this NEP depends on the content making. That is what is remains. So what way this content making process that has been secured in this exercise? Another thing already, Anirvanji has said that from affiliation system to autonomy, that shifting. How can it be a little bit standardization is required? How it is taken care of, because standards are, if you leave everything to the concerned college, the levels of different college may differ. So how that can be a standardized, that is there. Another thing is the yardstick between public and private institutions. This is also become the thing, how you look at that thing. Another aspect is unchecked commercialization is promoted by this NEP. That is one allegation. This corporate entities will be there, privatization will be there. Public, the role of public institutions, especially in rural area, without public funded institution, India cannot move forward rural education. So whether that will be affected by this thing, what are the precautions taken on that aspect? Then, decision making has been more centered in the executive bureaucracy. Even the parliament or state government, their powers are being now given to bureaucracy. This is this thing. This how that is there, that can be there more than academia. It is the bureaucrats who are going to run these institutions. So how you are looking at this thing? Then vocationalization, that you have started a new direction, but the details of vocationalization, that is not there in the report. So in what way that is there? Another thing is the English medium starts only at a later stage, English study. But many parents in the urban area, semi-urban area, they are all very much worried about this aspect, because in a state like Tamil Nadu and Kerala, where English is more prominent than other languages, there it is the parents are little worried. They want even in the prime, even the today the even the pre-primaries is filled with English studies. So that is there. Then another thing is, you have explained already, there multiple entry and exit. This system, whether it will create a anarchy in education, this is a question that is raised. Another question is postdoctoral studies, that is not given importance in the report. Postdoctoral studies, is it true? Is it, it's a question of fact, is it true, or what you have said about this? Then another thing is, all these changes are taking place in the primary level, pre-primary level, higher level, higher education level. How far these changes will going to affect the teachers? The teachers who are working there, because their salary, their promotion chances, their working, today's working system, burden, everything, how those things will be affected. And lastly, I would like to ask almost all the this 6% for education. This is the 1962 demand. 1960, I think. Sridharji has eyes. Sridharji, you are hearing? Okay. 1962. So, is it suitable for the current perspective? We are living in 2020. So, these are some of the reservations which we have heard while I have participated in many discussions on NDP. So these are some things. So I would like to hear directly from the horse's mouth these things. With these words, I conclude. Thank you. Thank you once again for being a part of this historical endeavor. Thank you.
Very nice of you, I think, by raising so many questions. I am also getting an opportunity to... Aisa, may be karao. Aisa. I think. Thank you very much. With regard to personality development, especially school education, we have said a very important principle. Curricular, co-curricular, and extracurricular, there will be no walls. Everything is curricular. So you are actually promoting all dimensions of personality from day one. This is one thing. Second thing, even when it comes to question of higher education, see, the entire concept of 3 or 4 years without any segregation of science, arts, commerce kind of a thing, you can pick up anything, different combinations, in the form of major and minor. See, for example, I'll give an example. If somebody is studying physics as a major, in the present context, the fellow can never go out of physics or science. But in this, you can take any kind of minor. So that freedom is there. And when it comes to the school, there is an interesting part which will take care of the personality development. The report card of each student is based on 300 360 degree appraisal of the student. First time in our country, the report card will consist of a report on which skill the student is strong. And for this sake, artificial intelligence will also be brought in. So like this, all these dimensions, primarily giving choice to the student, giving students a place to pursue their passion. इसलिए मैं एक वाक्य में इस पॉलिसी को मैं एक दिन पहले जो कुछ सेशन में मैं भाग ले रहा था वहां मैंने बोला कि ये पॉलिसी आई दिमाग को एड्रेस करता है और दिल को भी एड्रेस करता है. दैट इज द काइंड ऑफ अप्रोच. विथ रिगार्ड टू कंटेंट मेकिंग, वी हैव सेड दैट नेशनल करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क विल कम आउट बाय 2021. एनसीईआरटी विल फर्स्ट कम आउट विथ a national curriculum framework for early childhood care and education, because first time an effort is being made. And we have taken care to say all local traditions, Indian approaches have to be done and all that. And then it is not syllabus, sir. Let me tell you, curricular framework is not syllabus, is not curriculum. It's a framework, basic principles and what is to be done. Then on that basis, the textbooks will be written, and the textbooks will also always be, you know, even though they may be developed by NCERT and national bodies, but there is a percentage that states can change, a percentage that districts can change, a percentage that local context can be brought. So that's why the entire curriculum, there is an approach for national approach, and there is also a great provision for local context. Affiliation system, what you said, what about the standardization? The affiliation system, even though we have said by 2035 it has to be removed completely, it can happen a little early also. What will happen is the colleges will have to become multidisciplinary on one hand, and then little bigger in size on the other. Now what we are having is any number of small colleges dispersed everywhere offering one single program. Let me give an example. 40% of the colleges in our country, they offer only one program. Only one program. 26% of the colleges, they have enrollment of less than 50. Less than 50 in a college. So they are not viable. So if you want to bring about that college atmosphere, and if you have to make it little effective, size is one thing and multidisciplinarity is another. So like that it will start. And even this autonomy, it will not be given zero autonomy, 100% autonomy. No, it will be called graded autonomy. That means degrees of autonomy will be given over a period of time. You will be given some autonomy, then you will be seen how you perform, then you will be given the next grade, then the next grade. And finally, when you go for grading, when you get the highest grade, then only you will be given the degree granting power. And this entire thing is based on accreditation. It is not based on some visit of some people and some members going and visiting. It is completely based on accreditation system. And that framework will be developed by National Accreditation Agency, NCA, NAC. National Accreditation Council. With regard to public and private, what we have said is the regulation and other norms are equally applicable to public or private. No differentiation. At the same time, they will be exhausted to, they'll be subjected to light but tight regulation. You will not control everything, but you will identify the critical components of regulation and you will go very hard on that. For example, auditing is one issue. The second is public disclosure of whatever you do. Third is transparency. All these things will come in, and only on that basis, and your accreditation and things like that will be the basis. Then commercialization. See, no doubt I have also seen people saying, you know, commercialization will happen. See, the entire policy very clearly says that education is for public good. Commercial privatization, no. In school education, as well as in higher education, we have our emphasis on how to strengthen public institutions. For example, government schools. We have said there is a system called school complex, school cluster, and the quality of the government school must improve. The learning outcomes of government school must improve. It is not mere continuation of the government school. So that's why commercialization, and there is a complete accountability mechanism that we have brought, that the regulatory mechanism will brought. And the bureaucracy, I don't think that bureaucracy will also have any role, because every institution will be governed by independent board of governors without any external interference. And even if some funding and things like that happen, it is based on institutional development plan. See, for example, every institution will always prepare for every year. This is what is my plan for the year. And that plan will be discussed and accepted. And next year, when a review happens, it is always with reference to the plan that is being given, not on any ad hoc basis. Then occasionalization, no doubt that great details are not there, but the principles are given. That is, occasionalization is not separate. It is part and parcel of school education and higher education. It has been brought into a mainstream, not a separate system. And then the English medium, see, what we have said is, this is the recommendation of the policy. Wherever possible, you offer mother tongue up to 5th grade, preferably up to 8. And naturally, we have very clearly said in the policy, no language is imposed. Out of 22 languages as per Schedule 8, the 3-language formula comes into picture, and it is for the state governments to take a policy and to decide what kind of a thing happens. But one thing what I am looking forward, the kind of decentralization that we have started in this policy through school complex, 15-20 schools coming together and coming as a school complex. I think that decentralization will be more and more in the days to come. I think many of these language-related issues can also be settled, because you need to take a decision in a micro unit, not in a bigger unit. And then entry exit, multiple entry exit, whether it will create anarchy. No, in fact, it is completely will be based on credit system. There will be an academic bank of credit. When somebody enters and when somebody exits, that bank of credit will be there, and on that basis only it will happen. And one thing what I would like to say is the entire bodies will come out with national higher education qualification framework. National higher education qualification framework, which will give a complete framework for all these things. So therefore, that will not go anywhere. Postdoctoral, what you said, it is only a mechanism. If somebody wants to do it, it is always possible. You know, tenure track mechanism, what we have said, especially for higher educational institution, we have said tenure track and then extended tenure track. There you can always bring in postdoctoral. We might not, the policy might not have used the term postdoctoral, but it amounts to same. Then about teachers, you said you had an apprehension, you know, whether it will disturb and things like that. This 5+3+3+4, whatever that we have said, we have very clearly stated in the policy, this should not affect the physical infrastructure of the schools. This is only at the education level, but this is not to divide and send that school that way, bring this here, so the teachers will not be disturbed. And lastly, 6% of GDP, what you said. In fact, the original, the draft report, whatever that we have submitted, Kasturangan Committee, we have actually deviated from this percentage of GDP business. We have actually made it as outlay. In every year, total public outlay, what should be the percentage for education? It is around 10% today, and we have recommended to take it to 20% over a period of next 10 years. So every year, that 1% has to be increased. But when finally when the policy was announced, you know, it was restricted to 6% of GDP. But one silver line what I have is, even if it is 6%, in fact, Dr. Kasturangan has written in the preface to that report, you know, 6% of 3 trillion economy, 6% of 5 trillion economy, 6% of 10 trillion economy makes lot of difference. And it is said that whatever we have calculated, even 6% of 10 trillion economy is more than enough for education. Our economy, as and when it grows, the rate remaining same, the percentage remaining same, but the quantity available will be more. So that is the kind of approach. I hope I answered all the issues.
Wonderful. I think this has become a very interesting dialogue. I mean, I think this is exactly, I wish many more had joined, but I also want to say that this is being done live and we are recording this entire proceeding to be able to then push it through the social media across the country. So nothing is lost in the sense, but the manner in which the questions were asked, the manner in which you have answered, I think this is fascinating. It's getting into a very interesting dialogue. And I'm really very delighted that such seniors have given their time and they are here with us. So I want to then now, as we are nearing the end, I want to say Professor Kanak Sabapathy also has joined, member ICSSR, and also lately vice president of Tamil Nadu BJP. But his identity is that of an educationist, of a thinker, of a social activist also. So welcome, sir. I would request Sri Sundaram ji to kindly come in here with your observations. Yes.
Thank you, Dr. Anirban, I for making me part of this very enlightening discussion this afternoon. In fact, Professor Sridhar has made a very hot afternoon in Madurai, 3:30, a very pleasant one. My previous speaker, my best friend Sajid Narayanan, made Sridhar give another second speech. So I was searching for a question, but I am not able to ask anything. But the only thing I want to join Anirban Ganguly, that the situation in Tamil Nadu. Now the anti-Hindi mood in Tamil Nadu has outlived its utility. Today morning, a reporter was stating to me, out of 1 crore 20 lakh students today, 60 lakh students have the option of studying.